both of you. Let's start in a wide leg forward fold. Just let the head and the hands drop. You might need to put a little bend into the knees as you go down. Take some time there. You can kind of move your body as much as you want to. And take a big breath in and sigh it out. Let's go up to standing. Bend into the knees. And then just bring yourself up. Take your time, like you're just waking up your spine. Big stretch out, arms to the side, maybe face up toward the ceiling. And just drop your arms by your side. You can close your eyes here and just feel your feet root down into the floor. Let's start to get a breathing pattern. So we want you to work to draw your breath in and out of your nose. You can even put your hand on your belly just to feel that it's going really deep, not only into your chest, but using that diaphragm as well. As you start to breathe deeper like this, you might put a slight constriction at the back of the throat, Ujjayi Pranayama. Start to sweep the arms out and up, big stretch toward the ceiling. Let's get a little side bend here. Drop your right hand to your right thigh and just reach your left arm up and over. It's not like Sky Archer. You don't turn the toes out. You just stay where you are. Come back through center, other side, left hand, left thigh, right arm reaches up and over. Your gaze can go up toward that right arm or down toward your left toes. Come back through center, reach both hands upward, and then forward fold. Come right back down into that wide leg forward fold. Take a halfway lift here. So fingertips can stay to the floor, or if they don't touch, you can always bring your hands to your thighs or your shins. We're going to wiggle the feet closer together, guys. We're going into a low yoga squat, so you might want to keep your feet about hip distance or a little further apart. Just come on down. Wiggle into it, adjust as much as you need to. And if you're here or can't get here, it's uncomfortable, or you just don't feel like you should be there, forearms to your thighs are always, they always work that way. And go ahead and set your left hand down. Start to reach your right arm up into the air. It's a low yoga squat with a twist. Change sides real slow. Bring that right hand down, left arm goes high. Let's go ahead and bring that left hand down. And just roll your head around for a moment. Some movement, some motion in the neck. Maybe there's a place you want to pause. Come back through center. We're going to send the right leg out. I know it's kind of mirrored, but right leg out to the side. It's almost like a ninja, right? Right leg is straight. We're going to go into that same twist, guys. Left hand down, right arm reaches high. Then as you come out of this low twisting lunge, so here's how it goes. Right hand comes down to the floor. You're going to turn over your left shoulder. Roll onto your right toe, send the left arm high up into the air. Now left hand comes down. I want you to set your right knee down onto the floor. Left leg goes behind you, three limb tabletop pose. Let's get a squeeze in three times, guys. Knee to nose. So we want you to round and rock. Inhale, extend and lift. Two more times. Extend for that last time. We're going to step it back up between the palms. So left foot to the top. And then walk yourself into that ninja-like pose. Back into the first start. the beginning. Right foot comes in, guys, so you shift your weight into your left foot. You might have to wiggle or just step. Let's try the other direction. So shift the weight into the right foot, left leg extends. Right hand will stay down for that first twist, so your left arm goes up, you're opening toward that left leg. Middle low twisting lunge, so left hand comes down, returning toward the right shoulder. So you keep turning, 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 until you face the back side of that long side of your mat. Right hand comes down, left knee drops. We're headed into that three-legged table, right leg extends behind you. Three times, pull it in, knee to nose. Inhale, extend. Exhale, squeeze. Extend. Squeeze. Get that last extension, guys, and step it up. Right foot in between the palms. And then come right back into that half low yoga squat, which just happens to look like a ninja. Left foot comes in. So you come back into that low yoga squat for a moment. Kind of adjust yourself. And then we're taking it into a forward fold, so start to straighten the legs, drop the head. Again, feel free to catch some movement here. And take a halfway lift, breathe in. And then fold in and breathe out. Come on up to the top, so root down through your feet. You can even press your palms into your feet to say, stay there. Roll your way up, get a big stretch through your arms. Let the palms come together up top. Just slide them down in front of your heart. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, forward fold. We're gonna do that two more times. Pause here for a moment. And then take a halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, fold in. Come up to the top as you inhale, big stretch, big lift. Take up some space, palms come together, slide them down in front of your heart, maybe a little smile. And then inhale when you're ready, stretch tall. Exhale, forward fold all the way down. One more time, guys, halfway lift, breathe in. Fold in and breathe out. Let's rise to standing. Take your time, no hurry to get there. You can even pause the video if you need to. Palms come together, slide them down. Yeah, and then inhale, reach up. Exhale, forward fold. Take a halfway lift, guys, and this time, come back into that wide leg forward fold. So you can step, wiggle, you can even hop your legs really wide. We're just gonna come into a twist. So your left hand can stay here. You can move it closer to your right foot if you need to. Left hand down, right arm up, so it's a twist. Try to keep length through the spine. And changing sides. You can keep the chest lifted or drop it down. Right hand stays toward the floor. You can move it over toward that left foot if you need to. Left arm goes high. Left hand comes down, just a forward fold, so let it drop for a moment. Bend the knees, head to the top, slow roll. When you get to the top, instead of taking arms out, arms down, guys, and just start to get some shoulder rolls. So start by rolling them backward, or if it feels more familiar, you can roll them forward first. Then go ahead and start to roll them in the opposite direction. Even if it looks funky. Nice. And then get that big stretch just because it feels good. Palms come together, slide them down in front of your heart. Drop the arms by your side. Go ahead and turn the toes out a little bit, guys. Bend the knees. Sink the hips down, so you're opening through those inner thighs. We're gonna get a little side bend here. So I want you to set your right forearm down onto your right thigh. Start to reach your left arm up and over. Keep your chest nice and open. Come back through your center, head to the other side right away. So left forearm down, right arm reaches up and over. Your chin can go up or your gaze can go down. You can keep your eyes closed here. Come back through center. Both arms reach up and go ahead and straighten the legs. Nice. Left toes turn in a little bit. Right toes turn out. We're going to do that same motion. It's going to become extended side angle. So I want you to bend your right knee. Forearm to thigh. Left arm goes up and over. That left leg is straight this time. Keep breathing deep. That Ujjayi Pranayama, that little slight constriction in the throat. And from here, guys, we're gonna try to head to revolved triangle. So both legs are gonna go straight. Left hand comes down, maybe inside of that right foot. You're probably going to want to step in with that back foot. Right arm goes high. Great place to have a block here to prop yourself up. Standing splits, right hand comes down. You're gonna get a little kick off of your left toes. Drop your head. Work your chest or your nose toward that right knee. And let's come into a curtsy tuck real low, guys. Knee behind knee. If you need to, you can always set your left toes down for support. If you can, float it, maybe even with the hands as well. We're going to step really strong back to a warrior A. So I want you to plant your back foot, rise with a bent front knee, hips as square as you can toward that front knee. Let's open it up, warrior B. Keep breathing. Sky Archer. So that left hand can come to thigh or maybe wrap around your back, straighten your right leg. Take that right arm, stretch up, up and over. And just for a moment, guys, on the exhale, come back into that warrior B. It'll just help to transition us. Then I want you to straighten the right leg, turn the right toes in, and you're in that star pose. Let's go down, wide leg forward, full, just let it drop for a moment. Let's find halfway lift, get a nice flat back, hands to hips, and come up nice and strong on the inhale. Nice arms go up into the air. Let's try the other side. So left toes turn out. You're going to bend into that left knee. There's your platform. There's your shelf. Left forearm coming down. Right arm reaching up and over. This is your opportunity to kind of challenge your own strength. Maybe it's not physical strength today. Maybe it's a little mental. You don't have to wait for those things happen during the day to practice breathing. This is our practice. into revolved triangle. Right hand comes down. You're turning your chest a little bit toward the floor first, and then toward that backside, long side of your mat. Left arm reaches high. Left hand comes down, standing splits, a little kick off of those back toes, drop the head. Here's curtsy tuck, guys. Knee behind knee, so you want to sink your hips down instead of staying really high. Get low. You can always tap toes to the floor if you need to. You can practice floating it. Or maybe fall over. Warrior A, strong as you step back. Plant the back foot first and then rise. Left knee bends, arms reach high. Warrior B, open the chest, arms open front to back or somewhat front to back. Those wrists coming in, hovering right over top of the ankles. So you kind of look, wrists over top. Sky Archer, straighten that left leg. Find out what you want to do with that right hand. Thigh, back, left arm reaches. Get a little stretch through the left side of your body. Right back into that Warrior B for a moment. Bend into your left knee, open your arms. Straighten the left leg, then turn the toes in. Let's get a drop, guys. Forward fold. Take a halfway lift here. I'm gonna have you wiggle the big toes together. So you're just gonna toe heel, toe heel. You can jump as well if you'd like. And so your feet come closer together. You might touch those big toes. And then fold back in. I want you to start to bend the knees. Sink the hips back, guys. Come on up into chair. Really strong belly here. So tailbone tucking under. Kind of a little swoop there. Fingertips up toward the ceiling. So strong. If you haven't been feeling it lately, I'm here to tell you. See if you can sink a little bit deeper, just noticing if your knees start to jut or jet forward, sink your hips back. And take a big breath in. Give me a forward fold here, fingers toward toes. Take a halfway lift, and as you do, just get those feet about hip distance apart and then fold back in. Headed into a twist. Left hand will stay down, left knee bends, guys. Right arm reaches high. Changing sides, nice and slow, no hurry to get there. Right hand low, right knee bends, left arm lifts. Go ahead and bring that left hand down. Let's get a nice hamstring stretch. So I want you to take a halfway lift, and if you can, first two-piece fingers on each hand, hooking onto your big toe. If you can't, just come into a forward fold. If you can, guys, get that bind and then fold in. I want elbows out, pulling your chest toward your thighs. Take a halfway lift. We're gonna do another bind. Try hands underneath of your feet. So that means fingers toward ankles, toes toward wrists. Again, if that's not doable, you're just folding in, or maybe staying with that hook of fingers to toes. If you have it, same thing. Bend the elbows, pull yourself deeper. So pick up those toes, go ahead and take a halfway lift. This time low yoga squat, so you might need to move your feet a little further apart to get the hips nice and low. You can kind of sway and rock and settle yourself in. Whenever I come into a low yoga squat, one of my favorite things is just to tuck myself in. So you might want to round through the neck and tuck your chin in toward your chest. Lift yourself up, hands behind you. We're coming into seated, guys. So I want you to crisscross your ankles and just sit really, really tall here. Make it another roll of those shoulders, just like we did when we were standing. And then take the arms way up into the air. So you might stretch out in front of you or out to the side, big stretch. Headed into a side bend again, this time on the floor. So right hand to your right side of your body. Left arm reaches up and over, and you might even be able to come down onto your forearm here, but just as needed. Lots of opening through the side ribs today. And creating length, come up through center and just change sides. Left hand comes down and you get that lean to the left as the right arm goes up and over. Come back through your center, both arms go up. We're gonna bring the hands to the knees, guys, so keep that body nice and tall. Just drop and wrap your hands around the front side of your knees. We're gonna go into some seated cat-cows, and it's just gonna warm our spine up for the rest of the day. We do so much movement with the spine, so just start little. You might even just start with the chin lifting, and then the chin curling in. And your shoulders might get involved, so you lift the chin and the shoulders pull back a bit. And then the chin toward the chest and your shoulders roll in a bit. And then it just kind of travels down your body. So your chest and your chin and your belly, and then your back comes in and starts to round. And you might pull back to stretch the shoulders. And you lift the heart. And round it in just a few more times. Like getting a forward fold and a back bend a bunch of times. And then just come back to a neutral spine. Arms go up again. We're going to finish with a twist. So, right hand goes behind, left hand onto your right knee. Sit really tall as you turn. Come back through center, arms go up. Exhale, change sides, left hand behind, right hand onto that left knee. Through center, arms go up, guys, big stretch. And then exhale, bring the hands down and just rest them onto your thighs or your knees. We're gonna take a big breath in together and sigh it out. And I'm gonna cut the video here. But I encourage you to take a really long shavasana. Sometimes that doesn't mean just laying on your back. Sometimes it means staying here and just meeting yourself where you are. Maybe a few moments of meditation. Do what you feel is right for your body, and I will see you soon. From my heart directly to yours, namaste.